If we just take a break right now, the people are watching us. If they're like, okay, I'm with you. I need to do something about my sleep. I gotta go home and sell my household. Like, what are some of the big things that you must have people come up to you on a regular basis and say, I'm having a problem here and there. What are some basic things that people can do to get a taste of what it's like to get a regular night's sleep? What are some of those things that are just glaringly obvious to you in most people's situations?
Regularity is probably key. If there's one piece of advice I could give, it would be go to bed at the same time and wake up at the same time, no matter whether it's the weekend, the weekday. Regularity is king. And of all of those things, it's probably the wake-up time. Try to keep your wake-up time constant. That would be the first piece of advice. The second is, again, comes back to darkness. You know, try to reduce the light that you have in your house in the last hour before bed. You know, dim half the lights. It's not just screens. You know, it's overhead electric light. You don't need all of the lights blazing in the last hour before bed. And they did a great study with this where they asked people, you know, what's your habitual bedtime? And they would say, let's call it 11 p.m. That's when I feel tired and I go to bed. Then they took them on a camping trip up to the Rocky Mountains. And there was no electric gadgetry whatsoever, not even a car light. There was nothing. And they were shrouded in darkness. And they came back to sort of, you know, the natural rhythms of nature. And lo and behold, firstly, they started going to bed and feeling sleepy at 9 p.m. rather than 11 or 11:30. Firstly, they said that they would typically get six and a half hours of sleep, and that's what they needed. They started to sleep 9 hours. And they gave them almost a two-week period. So this wasn't just a rebound from their sleep deprivation. They consistently started to sleep 9 hours. And we see this routinely as well. If you unbuckle everyone from everything, connection, family, put them no sort of choice, but just sleep naturally how you wish. They sleep about 9 hours.
Okay. But do you believe in blue blockers and like different frequencies of light as you get?
In terms of the blue light glasses, there was a paper that was published about 14 months ago now, where they use these blue light lenses. Sorry, they use these yellow glasses to block out the blue light. And they found that there was about a 50 to 60% increase in the amount of melatonin that was released in these individuals relative to when they weren't wearing them. And melatonin is a hormone that is released when darkness happens. It's been called the vampire hormone because it kind of comes out at night, or the darkness hormone. And we need melatonin to time the healthy onset of sleep. But when we're bathed in electrical light at night, it slams the brakes on the release of melatonin in our brain. So our brain keeps thinking that it's daytime, even though it's night. And that delay in our melatonin rhythm, it puts us, you know, here in London, it will put us halfway to New York if we read an iPad for an hour before bed. That's the striking delay in melatonin that happens. Using those glasses does actually seem to help. Now, I don't know about particular makes or models and whether the quality control is there. It's a bit of a wild west right now. But certainly I think, you know, there was a study that demonstrated that that was beneficial.
This is a real issue. You need to really dim or darken all of those lights in your house hours before bed.
Yeah.
Stay off those bright screens.
I think we underestimate that, you know, and you can just think about it for yourself. You know, if you were to go away to like a farmhouse for a, you know, a holiday, and the guy says to the, you know, the generator is a bit faulty, sometimes it goes out. Maybe the generator goes out at 6 p.m. You've got no electricity. Your phone lasts for the last 2 hours. Then it's candlelight. My guess is that most people would go to bed significantly earlier. Part of it is because they don't have too much to do and the electronic invasion of technology into the bedroom isn't there anymore. But also, don't fool yourself into thinking that it's not about light. It very much is about light.